So what are challenges? I've talked about a lot of things. Let me summarize. One of our biggest challenges right now is to help women graduate better. A lot of women run what we call income-generating activities. These are self-employment-based businesses. They, as I said, they, because of the triple burdens that they have, on them, they tend not to go into very sophisticated and profitable businesses. So our next challenge is to try and see how many businesses of the 300,000 women that run businesses, how many of them can graduate to small enterprises? How many of them can become employers of other people in their community? So that is our next challenge. The natural progression is only 5%. Only 5% women move to loan sizes of $1,000 that the bank offers. So we want to actually add what we call a gender incubation lab, where we are going to pick up 10,000 very talented women and provide them the wherewithal to grow their businesses. So our challenge is, how can women graduate to larger businesses, transform their businesses? How can they have greater control over their income? That is something we still have to work on. How do they make the direct choices and what happens with their money? How do we reduce the burden on them? How can we reduce the drudgery of their lives in terms of, now they have to run businesses and they also have to manage their families? How do we further enhance men's respect for women? How do we create greater variety of products that are women-friendly, whether it's in insurance, or whether it is in lending, or whether it is in sales? And how do we have women counted as part of the economy, as entrepreneurs? So these are some of the challenges that we see today. I'd like to share something that we are very proud of. You only hear bad things about Pakistan. In New York Times in August 2009, one of our very, very successful Bajis, as we call her, sister, Baji is an Urdu word, but her sister, was featured in the New York Times. And her story I'd like to share with you. Her name is Sana Muhammad. I don't know how many of you know Nicholas Kristof. He's a writer, he's a journalist. And he came and spent time with us in Kash some time back. He's also written a book called Half the Sky, which is apparently a Chinese proverb, which talks about women holding up half the sky. So I just like to end by sharing Saima's story. When Saima came to us, her husband was indebted. He had taken money to set up a grocery store. It hadn't really worked. And his creditors were harassing him. And he was on the verge of selling the home that they lived in. That was their only asset that they had. So she came to Gulf and she said, she's a very feisty woman. And when this all happened, she decided that it was time to take charge. It was time to make a decision. And she had learned about Akash through word of mouth. And she approached us and said she wanted a loan of 10,000 rupees to start a business of handled word of presents. As time went on, this was the initial impetus. As time went on, today she not only did she start her own business, she also employs other women, 35 other women from her community are also part of her business. And she's been with us for almost 10 years. And today she has three daughters. All three daughters go to school. Not only do they go to school, she's also sending them to what she calls English medium schools, because she wants them to be either engineers, doctors, or lawyers. So thank you very much for your time. It's been a pleasure.